Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to 2023. Today we'll be having our very first webinar titled Crafting a Compelling Roadmap, Personal Vision and Mission Statement for HR Professionals. And we have one of our very own here, Irene Obagwu, who will be facilitating this session for us. All things being equal, we also have one of our colleagues who will be sharing with us briefly after our presentation. Thank you so much for joining. Do not hesitate to reach out to your friends, colleagues, loved ones who can benefit from this particular episode. As always, we will surely record this and upload it on our YouTube channel so that you can watch it over and over again. Irene is a graduate of guidance and counseling. She has a master's in personnel psychology from the prestigious University of Ibadan. She's an HR professional with over 12 years experience. Currently, Irene is the head HR and admin at CloudFlex Computing Services Limited, and she has a passion for personal development. Again, facilitating the topic, crafting a compelling roadmap, personal vision and mission statement for the HR professional. Please, let's receive with warmth and appreciation Irene Obagwu. Over to you.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir, for that intro. Good evening, everyone. It's a real privilege to be sharing your evening with me. I do not take it for granted. I'm happy to be doing this. Happy 2023. It's a year we've been looking forward to. Okay. So without much ado, I am going to drop a disclaimer. I am a shameless learner. Forget that I'm facilitating this session for us. We're all here to learn, unlearn, and relearn. And most importantly, to find a way to create a better 2023 for us. As the topic has said, is crafting a compelling roadmap for personal vision and mission statement for the HR professional. So what is personal vision and mission? How do we craft it? What our ideal self is, what we'll be looking at here today. We're going to be interacting, basically. I'm only here as a moderator. So as we go, we're going to have to talk about how to plan for the year 2023. Thank you, everyone, as we listen. I would like that we get interactive. So please, after some time, I'm going to be asking us to also let's have your input. Thank you. Okay, so am I audible? Can everyone hear me? I would appreciate if I get feedback so that I know I'm not talking to myself. Please let me see. I'm looking at the responses. I'd like to know that everyone can hear me. If you can hear me, just give me a thumbs up.
You are audible. Just continue to flow uninterrupted.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so I'm going to be introducing to the topic. As we all know, it's a new year. We're used to setting goals and new year resolution, old with the new, out with the old, in with the new. Okay, we are in a period where we're shedding the old and embracing new things. It's a period where we're setting goals and aspiration for the year. But have we thought about writing our own mission and vision statements? Okay, I'm asking if we have thought about writing our own vision and mission statements, because it's not just all about saying what you will do or what you'll not be doing again. So how do we even craft this powerful, sustainable vision and mission statement to take us through the year? Yes, how do we go about setting what we want to do, how we want to do it, and how we're going to be achieving it is basically what we're here to do tonight. Okay, so what is a vision and a mission statement? Basically, a vision and mission statement is a paragraph that summarizes everything you want to be and do in your personal life. It's a picture. It's like when you snap a picture and you look at it, it's like a picture of the future. When you write those statements, you picture the future and you put your statement down. That's basically what a vision and mission statement it is. So it defines the success, like, okay, when we succeed, how will success look like? It's like how will you define success? Apart from defining success, picture what success will look like to you. That's basically what the vision and mission statement helps you to do. Yeah, each and every one of us have our own vision and mission statement. They look completely different. What a vision or mission is to me, it's not going to be what it will be to Victoria or Mr. Oluyemi or any one of us on this call. So it is important that we summarize the values, what are those things that are important to us, what are our aspirations, where do we want to be? And it is important that we summarize these things and read them out to ourselves until we get inspired by them. It's just like the way our daily affirmation is. When you write a vision and mission statement and you read it aloud to yourself, it reminds you of who you are, who you want to be, what you are doing to get to wearing your vision and mission statement. Okay, yeah? I would like to ask, do we think vision and mission statement are different? Do we agree that a vision is different than from a mission statement? I'd like to have a few responses because I like to know that we're interacting. The chat box. So vision statements are different from mission statements. Even though they do similar things, they have differences. So we're going to take a deep look at how they are different. A vision statement is an holistic view of the future. It's your ideal self in the future. So when you put a vision statement out there, you're basically describing what you want your future to look like. You're saying those things you envision. So a vision statement basically defines the optimal desired future state. It's like a you have this diagram of what the future looks like in 2, 5, 10 years or more. It's a statement that describes what you want to achieve in the future. It inspires you to do your best and shape your understanding of what you are doing. That's what vision statement does for us. But a mission statement, on the other hand, is like a child of the vision statement. Yeah, you have a vision, you have what the future wants to look like, you have your desire, your long-term goal. Remember, I said vision statement is the future. Yeah, a mission statement is how you get to the future. A mission statement is more concerned with the current state rather than defining a long-term future state. It answers the questions, what am I doing? How am I doing? Who am I doing this for? So for everything you do, your mission statement helps you, is like, it channels you to your purpose. It helps you to realize why you're doing what you're doing in the first place. Your mission statement is your why. So a mission statement answers the questions, where do you want to go? It talks about the present leading to the future and how to get where we want to be. So here, I have sample vision statement. I would like if we could just drop a sample of vision and mission statement. This will help me to get in the chat box so that I can get other perspective. So I have sample vision statement here. For me, I've always wanted to be known for someone who inspires all people around me to do more. Like I am an advocate of you can be more, you know? So I tend to want to push people to do more, to like perform optimally to their full potential. Yeah, that's holistic. That's a big picture. Okay, how do I now make people to be able to do more? How am I able to push people to be more than they thought they could be? So the best way to do that is now to go back to my mission statement, which is to have everyone I meet more confident and use their full potential. Yeah, I have a bigger picture of wanting everybody to perform and do what they beyond what they are taught, like breaking the limits. How do I make people break the limits? And I have to come to a mission statement of how I would do it daily and over time. So that is going to drive me to my vision statement. Yeah, thank you, Victoria. Vision is where you are going. Mission is how you want to get to where you are going. Perfect. Okay, vision statement to be one of the most sought after HR professional in Nigeria and beyond. Great. Thank you. Just let's have them come in. Okay, so that's for the differences between vision and mission. So the meat of the matter today is, okay, I've taken us through what vision statement is and what mission statement is. I did share a link to the Year Compass. So with the Year Compass, basically what the Year Compass helps to do is it helps us to review the past year. It helps us to see how the past year had gone, the things that needs to be corrected, and what we want to move into the new year. So if we're going to be crafting a compelling roadmap, a vision and mission statement for the year that is going to drive us and help us to achieve our dream, for the purpose of this training or webinar, I would like us to look at using the Year Compass. The Year Compass basically helps us to set a good roadmap for the year. I'm going to be, I don't know if we have the Year Compass downloaded. I'd like to see, does anyone have the Year Compass downloaded? I'll be sharing the screen to explain how it works, but I'd like to know if some of us have the Year Compass downloaded already. I'm looking at the chat box to see, do we have anybody that has the Year Compass downloaded? Thank you, Oyelola. Thank you. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so we're not going to waste time. I'm also going to drop the link to the Year Compass. Should we have anybody that has not downloaded it? It's actually it's a very interesting booklet to run you through planning your year. I don't know if anyone has ever used the Year Compass before. Has anyone ever used the Year Compass before? I'd like to also know what your experience has been like using the Year Compass. Okay, thank you. So I'm going to be sharing, I'll stop sharing this slide and I'll share the slide to the Year Compass so that we can review 2022 and thereby continue to craft our roadmap of 2023. One minute, please. Okay. Apologies. I'm struggling with my change my I'd like to have response. Please, can we see my screen? Please type yes, I can see your screen. Please, can somebody unmute? Let me be sure my screen is showing.
Yes, we can see your screen. It's showing clearly.
Okay, thank you. I need that to be sure, please. Okay, so here's the year compass. We're going to be doing this exercise of closing year 2022. We're going to be reviewing year 2022 so that we can close on it and set a new roadmap for year 2023. So in this exercise, I will introduce to us the year compass, what it is. The year compass is a booklet that helps you to reflect on the past year and plan the next one with carefully selected questions and exercises. The year compass helps you to uncover your patterns and designs. So we're going to be looking at a few questions to get us ready for 2023. To get us ready, please get your pen and paper. If you have not downloaded, you can download this after. Trust me, it's something you want. Okay, so we're going to start by going through the past year. Sorry, am I still sharing? I think sharing stopped.
Well, I'm not seeing anything except for you now, so.
Okay, I'll share again. I'm trying to share it again. So can you see my screen now?
Yes, it's showing now.
Okay.
This past year.
So that's basically what we'll be doing. We're reviewing the year 2022. We're going through the year 2022. Okay, looking at this page, if you have your year compass with you, please kindly open to it. Let's go through it together. No worries if you don't have it. You can always download it and do this. Trust me, it's a rewarding exercise when you go through it. So we're going through the past year. Looking through the past year, look at your calendar week by week. What do you see? What is an important event? Family gathering, friendly get-together, or significant project? Write it down in this blank space. Just, we're going to take about 5 minutes to do a reflection on this. So just write down those things that happened in 2023, looking at January to December, week in, week out. What are those things that you see as important events that happened? So I'm going to pause a bit. So we'll do like, take like 5 minutes of reflection to do this exercise. Okay. Does anyone want to tell me, volunteers, please? Like I said, I want this to be interactive. Do you feel led? Do you think you're interested in sharing part of those things that were significant to you? What was important to you in 2020? You can just drop the comments in the comment section. I'll look at it and read it to us. What is one important thing you think? Or anyways, if the time is short for us to review, basically that is part of our review for next for the past year, so that we can craft a compelling roadmap for the new year. So I'd like to know. So leaving this calendar review, we're going to the very next session of our year compass. So this section wants us to look at what the year was all about. We live our lives through distinct but interconnected aspects. Let us take a look at areas below, the areas that are listed below, and ask ourselves what significant events in each of them. So we're going to write them down. That's why it is important that we downloaded this, because it's like a workbook for us to do this. So what were the significant events that happened in these areas of our lives? In our personal life, family, career and studies, friend and community, relaxation, hobbies, creativity. You know, we're going to look at them and just write down things that were significant in these areas of our lives. Like I said, for the purpose of today's webinar, we're just going to run through what the year compass does, because we'll not have the luxury of time to start filling all these things. They are not things we should actually fill in a hurry. You know, the year compass helps you to retrospect. It helps you to look at where you were, what you achieved, and where you want to be, basically. So taking us through this, then it takes us to the next one. After we've looked at the significant thing that happens in these areas of our life, in six areas of our lives, we then go to the next section, which is the sentences about our past year. Okay, if we were to write sentences to describe this our past year, the six sentences to describe our past year, we have the section where we look at and we can put down those things that we normally would not have thought of if we were drawing our New Year resolution. Those things, they are probing questions, questions that help us to reflect on how the year has gone. So in 2022, what was the wisest decision you made? What was the wisest decision I made? The biggest lessons learned, the biggest risk we took, the biggest surprises in the year. All these are areas that we need to sit down and review how the year went for us, so that we can close in on the year and be able to design better things for the year we are into now. The biggest surprises of the year, the most important thing you did for others, the biggest thing you completed, and all that. This also, when we leave those six sentences of the past year, it takes us to the next six questions about the past year. Okay, the past year, if we look at the past year, what was it like? What are we proud of in the past year? What are the three people, who are the three people who influenced you the most? Yes, this, sometimes we think, oh, nothing major happened, you know? But when you sit down with this year compass and you retrospect and you take, it's like you look back, a rewind of the year 2022. The year that you were thinking, probably nothing bigger, you discover that something actually happened. There are people in our lives that influence us positively or negatively. This is to help us look at those people that influenced us the most in the year 2022. We're doing all this review so that it helps us to map a better roadmap for the year 2023. Okay, who are the three people that influenced you the most? What were you not able to accomplish? Yeah, we set goals. We have the things we want to achieve. We have things, targets, we have things we are pursuing. Yes, most of the times we are not able to achieve everything before the year runs out. So what are those things that you were able to accomplish in year 2022? It is also important that we take note of that and also put them down here. What is the best thing you have discovered about yourself? Sometimes when we go through the year, there are certain things that happen to us that we don't even think, or that we never knew that there are things we are capable of doing. sometimes events happen, challenges happen, a lot of things happen, and we tend to realize that, oh, okay, so I have strength in this. But we tend to realize, oh, so I can do this. So it's a time to look back and see, what are those things that you have discovered about yourself? What are those things that you realize that, oh, this thing is a, like, there's this thing about me. Then what are you most grateful for? I'm an advocate of gratitude, being grateful. Honestly, gratefulness opens doors. Gratefulness, when you're grateful, you see a bigger picture. When you're grateful, you're not able to dwell on past or art or something. So gratefulness, what are you grateful for in the year 2022 that just passed? Yeah, the economy was tough, things was hard, Nigeria is hard, everybody's jackpying, you know? So what are those things you are grateful for, even in the midst of all these things going on? So that takes us to the very next session. I'm sorry, I'm having to just rush through because I'm basically explaining what we need to do to craft a compelling roadmap. It is very important, please, I'll pray the indulgence, to please go back, find a quiet time, relax, and look through this year compass and walk through it. Honestly, it's therapeutic, trust me. Ever since I discovered it, it's been like a therapy for me each year. Okay, so in the ups and downs of life, a lot of things happen. You also have the opportunity at this section to take a look at the moments that are memorable, joyful moments from last year. Yeah, just draw them. Just close your eyes, picture what the joyful moment from last year looked like. You know, how did you feel? Who was there with you? What were you doing when those great, joyful, memorable moments came? What kind of smell, sound, or taste do you remember? You know, whatever picture comes to your mind, once you get to this part of the year compass, just put it down. Anyhow, you don't have to be a great artist. Anyhow, you can draw those things that how it feels like, that it comes to your mind, you know? Okay. So that takes us again to the next part of the year compass, where we celebrate our wins. Yeah, in the past year, yeah, no matter the challenges, there are wins. Here you are able to look at the past year and also look at, okay, what did you accomplish? What was your biggest accomplishment? List the three greatest accomplishments from last year. You have the space to do that. Then what did you do to achieve this thing? Here you have identified those three accomplishments, those things that you accomplished greatly. You have identified them. It's good to identify what you did, but it's also good to identify those accomplishments, and it's also good to identify what you did to achieve this thing. It's just like reward, so that you know that, okay, that kind of behavior should be reinforced to continue to produce the results that you got. Who helped you to achieve these successes? Sometimes when we achieve things, there are people directly or indirectly involved. You might not even know. It is when you are now sitting back to look at this, like you want to answer these questions, who are those that really helped you to achieve this? That's when you are able to now realize that, oh, this person was instrumental in this. This person helped me in this. So it's also important that we take that with you and look at those that helped us to achieve the success. You may be wondering how. It's also important to know how they helped you to achieve the successes. So while we are celebrating our wins, life is full of challenges, we know. So it's also important we look at the three biggest challenges of last year and list them. What were the three biggest challenges you had last year? Who or what helped you to overcome these challenges? Yeah, when we have challenges, there are people we run to, there are people we quickly call that, ah, come and help me, I'm in this trouble and all that. It's good to also sit back and look at those people that helped you to achieve these challenges. What have you learned about yourself by overcoming these challenges? Yeah, the three challenges identified. There are also lessons to be learned. What have you learned from the challenges you identified? They didn't come your way for them to just come and go. No, there must be a lesson to learn so that you're able to deal with the challenges better when they come. Aha, now this is the biggest part. This is the part where we tend to hurt ourselves without knowing, honestly. Sometimes it's good to forgive people. It's good to forgive even your own self. We've made mistakes in the past and we're beating ourselves over and we're like, oh, why did I do this? And sometimes we hold back to it. And it has happened to me that something happened and it took me like almost forever to forgive myself. But trust me, when I forgive myself, the burden was lifted. It's also with forgiving people. Did anything happen during the past year that you still need to be forgiven? Deed of words, maybe somebody just said something to you and you're like, ah, no, this person said this, you know, and this person made you feel bad. Deeds or words that made you feel bad, or you are angry with yourself, just write it down. Do yourself good by forgiving. Just write down those things that you need to forgive. Anything that requires forgiveness, anything that you think you are still angry about from life, just as many as possible. If you have more than one thing that has annoyed you, or if you have more than one person that has annoyed you, as much as possible, just look at those things that need to be forgiven. Put them down. Then letting go. Yes, you have identified those things that need to be forgiven. You have identified the mistakes, the errors, the things you did to hurt yourself or that people did to hurt you. You know, there are some things that you have said, no, you cannot let go. It's time to let go, because holding back these things are like burden. They burden you. Sometimes you're even angry with some people and they don't even know you're angry with them, you know. So it is important that we let go. In letting go, is there anything you need to say? Is there anything you have to let go before you can start your next year, which is the year 2023? Yeah, the year 2023 has started, but is there anything that happened in the year 2022 that you really need to let go? You really don't need to burden the year 2023 with, you know? Just just reflect back and let go. Draw, write, then think about it and let it go. Let everything go. If anyhow it comes, just put it down. If it comes as a drawing, if it's a writing, just write it down at this section and just let it go. Aha. I would like us in the comment section again, so that I'm sure that this is interactive, to come and describe the past year in 3 words. If you were to choose 3 words to define your last year, 2022. What 3 words would you choose? I'm going to pause for 5 minutes and I'll look at the chat room. I'm sure I'm going to be saying very interesting words there. If we were to describe the year 2022 in 3 words, I would like to hear from us. I'm looking at the chat box. If you were to write what the year 2023 looks like in words, what would it be? Oh, fantastic. Uchenna said it was challenging. So can we have some more words? 3 words to describe 2022. Yeah, I agree with you. 2022 was challenging, but like they always say, we move. We move. Wow, challenging. I was insightful. Wow. Fun, good opportunity, and a bit of challenging. Tim Tokwe says, sincerely, it's a learning point in every area of my life. Wow. That's good. I'm happy to see that this is interactive. I'm happy to see that our evening is getting well spent. Thank you, everyone. Wow. Moses says it was a learning curve. Motivating. overwhelming at some point. Fun, yeah, it's good. We need to have a mix of both. It can't all be smooth, smooth, smooth. Like they used to say, if the road is just so smooth and everything is going, you are going to slip and fall. So we need those bumps sometimes in life to help us slow down. Insightful, Dele says insightful, fulfilling, and a learning curve. Yeah? Turning point, exposure, and overwhelming. Great. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone. Let's have them come. So is us describe our past year in 3 words. Now this takes us to we want to become year 2022. If it was a movie, if it was a book and you wanted to write a book, or if it was a movie that might just be having a movie coming out in Netflix very soon. If it was a book, what title would you give it? Yesterday says Lady Lifted by Grace. Trust me. We might just be having a movie coming out from this session. We might just be having a movie coming out from this session. Netflix will be on the lookout for us. Spiritual mentorship. Please, let's have more. Let's have more. Let's have more. Think about it. If the year 2022 was a blockbuster movie and you were the director, what title would you give to it? Whoa. Well, let me just say you can do more. Interesting. Let's have it. Unfortunately, we cannot do the filling of this yearbook together, this year compass together here. But trust me, if you find time to sit down with the year compass, there are questions that you never would have thought of. There are answers that you never know you have, and you're going to discover you have. Wow, if it was a novel, it would be coming to terms. Hi, Sosa. Nice one. Thank you. Okay, so we're going to be saying goodbye. Goodbye to last year, year 2022. Basically, what we have done is we have looked at the year, we have looked at the ups and downs, we have looked at the things that made us feel good, we have looked at how family and friends have been helpful to us. We have looked at the things that make us feel bad. We have looked at the things that we do not need to transport into 2023. So we're going to be saying goodbye to the year 2023. Sorry. Oh, I'm in a hurry. We're going to be saying goodbye to last year, the year 2022. Is there anything else left that you would like to write? Do it now. Session for us to actually feel this. We're going to take out some time and reflect. So when you are doing this on your own, it's very important that you settle down, think about those baggages you do not want to bring into 2023. Take your time, think about those baggages that you want to leave behind in 2022, that you don't want to hamper any of your flow in 2023, and just leave them behind. So here we say goodbye to year 2022, and we are done with the past year. We have just finished the first part of the year compass. So we're going to take a deep breath here, and we're going to look at the year in view. Okay, so when we're done with this, it's now time to move to crafting our new year vision and mission statement. So year 2023 has come. What do we want to happen in the year 2023? Dare to dream big. There's a session in the year compass where don't judge yourself. Just dream away, like What are those things you wish, if you like, call it fantasy, you know? Just what are those things that you wish you want to do in 2023? Just dream. What does the year ahead look like for you? Why will it be great? What are those things you think will make the year 2023 great? What would happen in an ideal world? Just picture, okay, in an ideal world, what 2023 will look like. You know, just write it down. Draw. If you are good at drawing, sometimes it's very good. If you can just picture what you are imagining and draw it down, you know, just let go of your expectations and dare to dream. Sometimes there's some thoughts that come to our mind that we're like, now, you know, dream big. Yeah. Then just put it down. Put it down. Anyhow it comes to your mind. In this session, just put it down. Then this is what, after you have dreamt big, you have looked at it, it's a vision, right? We're talking vision and mission. A vision is a bigger picture. So now you have had that bigger picture of what you want your 2023 to look like. It's now time to dice it down in bits. So this is what my next year will be all about. Well, when you get to that section where you take a look at the areas of your life and decide your goal for each of them, for the next year, which of course has started the year 2023, we're just closing on year 2022. So ideally, once you have done this and you have closing on year 2022, just forget everything you have written in year 2022. You have closed year 2022. It's time to focus on year 2023. Okay, you have looked at year 2022. In the process of looking at year 2022, there are things that have come to you that you have realized that you want to do in year 2023. There are things that have come to you that you know you want to let go in year 2023. So here you are going to craft what the year is all about. The year 2023 will look like for you. You put those goals on the page. This is the first step towards realizing them. Once you write your goals down, trust me, you are going to realize them. So personal life and family, career and studies, friends and community, relaxation, hobbies and creativity. Just look at those areas of your life and look at what you want it to look like in the year 2023. Just picture what you want it to look like and describe it in each of these sections. Just picture it and describe it in each of these sections. Aha, then this takes us to the magical triplet for the year ahead. I always love this part. The things, you're going to be writing three things each in each section. That's why it's called magical triplets. You're going to look at three things about yourself. What are those three things you like about yourself? If you never knew it now, this is an opportunity to also reflect and look at those beautiful three things you like about yourself and put it down. Then, three things you are ready to let go. We also have three things you want to achieve. The three people that will be your pillar during rough times. There are times that you need people, but because you never thought of the people, situations happen and you know, you're stranded. It is important at the beginning of the year for you to identify those people that if you know you're in a tight corner, if you know that, you need somebody to speak to, you need somebody to reach out to, people that let you be you, you know, people that will not judge you. It is important to identify these three people, those that you know that can be your support and you can call out to them. It's important to identify them and put them down here. Then what are those things you will dare to discover? Remember when the magical triplet section is a session where you look at three things in each of these aspects and put them down. What are the three things you will dare to discover? Like I was telling somebody yesterday that you can decide to dare to discover how water got into coconut too. No mind me. Okay. So what are those three things you want to discover? It's important to identify them. I will have the power to say no to these three things. This is very important. Sometimes not having the power to say no to certain things actually hamper our progress. We see ourselves putting too much on ourselves. We see ourselves, even when it's not convenient, yes, we should make sacrifices for people around us, but there are things we need to have power to say no to. If you've never thought about this before, It's time you think about it. What are those three things you need to have the power to say no to in this year 2023 that we're going into? You know, then this is also very important. It's good for our mental health and well-being. What are the things in your surround to make your surrounding cozy? That they can be very minute, very insignificant thing that you never paid attention to. It could be something as simple as a throw pillow. I like artworks. So when I was doing my 2021 year compass, it occurred to me that I actually wanted to have artwork pillow. So I made pillow artwork in pillows, you know, it was just something that are not, you never paid attention to, and it will give your environment comfort. It could be planting flowers. Just think about those things that if you know they're in your space, they're in your surrounding, you feel cozy and you make the place lively for you. Then it also takes us to our morning habits. What are the three things that you will love to do each morning? It's also important that you identify them. When you identify these three things you love to do in the morning, it's important that you put them down. Then what will you do to pamper yourself? We're always after Lagos. For those of us in Lagos, the hustle and bustle of Lagos is something else. We need to pamper ourselves. Honestly, we need to take care of ourselves. So it's important that we identify those things. It doesn't have to be expensive things. Just identify those things that you want to be doing to pamper yourself for the year and set how regular you want it to be. Is it weekly? Is it monthly? You know, anyhow, it's convenient for you. We'll just ensure that in the year 2023, you pamper yourself. There are places we dream of being. It's important that we also put this down, because when you put things down, it actually helps you to want to drive to achieve it. Things that you put down, trust me, there's a love to visit as the year goes by. Then how will you connect with your loved ones? Just identify three areas you want to connect with your loved ones. There's so much loneliness everywhere. There are people needing our attention that we don't even know. You know, we hear suicide and death. You know, it's not even about the people. Even we ourselves. So three ways that we want to connect with our loved ones, family, friends, you know, all the people around us. Aha! Then when we're hard on ourselves, you know, pushing hard, and trying to achieve our dreams. When we achieve these dreams, when we achieve these goals that we set for ourselves, how do we want to celebrate? How do we want to reward ourselves? Identify three things that, okay, when you set a goal in 2023 and it is time and you have reached that goal or you have accomplished something you set out to accomplish, it is important that you identify how you want to reward success. Is it that you want to take yourself out? Is it that you want to take yourself on a date? Do you want to go and see a movie? You know, do you want to go to the beach? Like I like going to the beach, you know? How do you want to reward success in 2023? It is very important that we also pay attention to that. Then this is another section where we sit down and have six sentences about our next year, our current year, which is 2023. This was happening in 2022. I would have said sentences about my next year. So what are the things, the sentences that we would like to write about the year? For example, this year, I will not procrastinate anymore over. Identify those things that you procrastinate about and write down what you will not be procrastinating about. This year, I will draw the most energy from. Find out those things that you can draw energy from. Sometimes we all need to refuel, you know? Sometimes we need a shoulder to lean on. Sometimes we just need a pat on the back where you want to be brave. Like the things that you either you before now will be scared of doing. Look at if you can overcome your fears and identify the areas where you will be brave at. This year, I will say yes when. You need to, just like in the previous session, we said you should know, identify the things you want to say no to. You should also know when you want to say yes. You should always know when you are being treated right. That's when you can say, okay, yes, this is okay. You should know when to say yes. This year, I will advise myself to, you know, it's like I used to say, it's good to have board meetings with yourself. So this year, what will you advise yourself to do? It's very important. This year, 2023, will be special for me because you need to identify what will make your 2023 special for you. It's going to be your driving force because it's like setting targets for yourself. If your 2023 is going to be special for you because of this, then you know you are going to try so hard to make sure you achieve it, you know? So that is also very important. Okay, so that takes us to another section. My word for the next year. What is one word? Pick a word. Sorry, now this is going to be your word for year 2023. So pick a word to symbolize and define the year ahead. You can look at these words if you need some extra energy, you know. Like I said, you should identify where you're going to draw your energy from, you know. So we understand that there will be ups and downs in the year. The year will be rough, it will be smooth. So those times when you need to draw energy, you know, you can come back to these words that you have put down. One magic word for the year 2023 that you have put down here. So each time you look at these words that you have put down here, it reminds you not to give up on your dreams. It reminds you that when the challenges come, it's just a phase. It's going to pass, you know? And this one is where you make a wish. It's a secret wish. You can just free your mind. You know, I'd say dare to dream big. Don't be scared. What is the secret you wish for your 2023? Just unleash your mind. Be imaginative enough to see what you will wish 2023 to be like. Just be free with yourself, you know? Like I keep saying, I always encourage people to do the year compass in a very serene place where they are all by themselves, where imaginations can come to play, where you can view your world and you can be able to visualize what your world will look like. So at this point, it is important that you also sit back, look at, make a secret wish and put it down. Aha, okay. So once we are done making our wish, it means that, yeah, we've planned the year. We are ready to kick start. We're ready to start crushing those goals. We're ready to set, yes, our vision and our mission and pursue our dreams with resilience, no matter what, and achieve results in the year. So this is very important. Congratulations, we have just planned our year 2023. If you are happy that the year 2023 has been planned, let me see your favorite emoji in the chat room so that I can show that the energy is as lit as I think it is, because I am happy. I'm always happy to review the year. It would be nice to see that this feels good. It would be nice to see that this makes sense. Whoa, I love those emojis. Thumbs up, the fist bump. Wow, 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 wow. Thank you. Yeah, I like the energy. It's important to get to understand that we should review ourselves, you know, and see how we are doing. Trust me, if you take the year compass as to it's out always.
Apologies, everyone. So sorry. Seems our network is a bit bad. I don't know. Can anybody hear me? Oh, okay. All right. Thank you. I'm trying to see if you can bring her back. But if not, we have to make it an interactive session while she. While she complete, while she come back online. So please kindly give us a few minutes. Let me see if I can get her back on track. But please, let's still be interactive while she's still back. What have we learned so far? Has it been so interactive? Let's just have a little mutual discussion while she's back. What have we learned so far? Can we share? Let's share the chat box, even with our emoji or our expression. What have we learned so far? What do you think? You think we can share with others that we can do better in this year 2023 in our career on how to at least be strategic and all other things? Please, can you let's share on the chat box while I still bring back our speaker for tonight? Okay, I'm still waiting for us. So please, let's share what we've learned so far this night on the chat box. We are trying to bring okay, I can see everybody. Learn. That is what it is for me. Wow. Awesome.
please let's share, let's just be interactive as possible. We're trying to see if she can come back due to network though, but if not, we'll still have to close with the Q&A a little bit, or if we have anyone that feel like sharing one or two things with us, please kindly raise up your hand so I can unmute you while you share. Oh, awesome. Insightful. Tululokwe, thank you. We are still waiting for more. If you have anyone that wants to share one or two things with us, please, you can raise up your hand while I unmute you to share further. Oh yes, Tolokwe, the recording will be provided on our YouTube channel. If you're not following, please, it will be dropped. The link will be dropped on the chat box anytime soon. It's provided, the recording will be available on our YouTube channel. All right, thank you, Mr. Dilukunyale. Very refreshing. And reminder of basic principles. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining this session this night. We really appreciate it. Even though with the Ozil and Buzzle of Legos, I don't know where other people are, our location, but we can definitely understand that it's good to be back. All right, okay. You're not seeing any other person or no one is ready to share any other thing with us. So we might have to close the session because it seems the network is not bringing back our speaker. Thank you. I'm just trying to see if I can bring her back. So at least just in case we have any Q&A so she can take it. Oh, definitely. I will drop in the YouTube link anytime soon, please. I will drop in it as soon as possible now. A minute, please. Oh, she's back. Okay. Let me unmute her.
Okay. Oh. Thank you, yes. Everyone. I've been back, I've been sending count on mute to you privately. I know you are busy.
All right, I'm telling everyone to share what they've learned so far this night.
Yeah, in fact, that is what actually brought me back. Yeah, we have reviewed 2022. We have planned 2023. Then what next? What did we learn? I've actually been reading comments since I came back. Like, it's been learning. Honestly, the first time I reviewed Year Compass, I was lost. Like, it was a year I thought nothing happened. But after the review, trust me, a lot happened. Like, I now had a lot to be grateful for. And that was the year I decided to start. Okay, I used to practice journaling, you know? And that was the year it occurred to me that I've been writing a lot. Why don't you publish? And that has led me to having two books that I'll be publishing this year. In fact, I've converted my gratitude journal into a journal to be published, you know? So when you retrospect, it actually helps you to see things that you didn't pay attention to, you know? So it's very, very important. I can see everybody is learn, reflection. Please, is there anything anybody wants to add? I don't know, Dr. Adetutu, you'll be closing the session. but do we still have any other thing? Do we have any inputs, contribution? I remember to finish your Year Compass and sign that contract with yourself. It's very important. When you finish the board meeting with yourself, it's important that you sign the contract so that you know it's binding. It is the contract for you, with you, and by yourself. So I don't know, while we're still trying to wait, for the session. Can we call it a wrap, or we are still trying to see if we have Q&A? Okay, so Dr. Adetutu, it's over to you.
Thank you so very much.
You're welcome. Wow. Am I the only one not hearing? Can we hear? I can't hear.
I think our network.
Yeah, the network is bad.
Yeah, our network is bad.
No, the network is. Can someone, Victoria, you two, you confirm that you're not hearing, right? Actually, can't hear. It's breaking. It's very glitchy. Or do you want to?
Yes, our network is bad.
Yeah.
Can anybody hear me now?
Yes, yes. I think it's better without the video.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Amazing. Okay. So, Irene, that was great. Thank you so much for those key points. Thank you for L, the foundation you've laid. I mean, it is a great thing. And I would like to congratulate my dear professionals for this opportunity that you have chosen to give to yourself. I will just be talking basically on adding to the foundation that Irene had just laid and talk about you. If you realize whatever we have talked about this evening has nothing to do with any other person but yourself.
Yeah.
While we are trying to, you know, build people's organization strategically, while we are trying to build people's life, catch those talents, develop those talents, make profit. Have you thought about what you're going to be doing for yourself? I was in a conversation with someone and then it pops up and said, let us pray. Then we prayed, oh, and the guy at the end of the day asked, I realize you prayed for XYZ. Have you prayed for yourself? It's not being selfish. Have you prayed for yourself? Then I realized that almost when I'm praying, we're interceding, doing all of them. Well, in year 2023, I want to encourage each and every one of us. The mission that you have written down, the goal that you have set, the vision on how you want to get there, let's make it actionable.
Hmm.
Take actions. You know, I don't know if it is just me, but when it comes to someone, you doing something for someone, it takes you less than 5 seconds to get it done for that person. When it now comes to you doing something for yourself, you take forever to get it done. I really want to apologize for the video. I don't know what happened in network things, but apologies about that. So, you know, let's take us serious this year. Take yourself serious this year. Tell yourself, call your name, Adetutu, I'm taking you serious. I'm going to love myself this year for once.
Absolutely.
Tell yourself that I have gone through a lot. I have gone through challenges. Rain has fell. The storm has come. Sun has come. Hamatan is hammering. What and what am I doing for myself this year? You know your vision. You know your mission. Write these things down into a SMART goal. All of us already know what SMART is, so I don't need to start defining what that is. Because it is yourself, make yourself a priority this period. Make yourself a priority 2023. If you need to get a new car for yourself, go ahead, buy that new car. If you need to drive, or you need to exercise, or you need to learn, whatever it is that you need to make yourself a happy and complete person, please do it. this life not be two, not only one.
Yes, sir.
I want to buy a car, a Venza 2022. I don't even have 5,000 in my account. By the time the salary even jump enter, everything I've carried it away. What have you done for yourself in that salary? Take yourself on vacation. Take yourself for medical checkups. We're not going to hear, in fact, somebody just stopped and died. Somebody, Dave, if you realize, those are things that they would have just prevented from happening, apart from natural cause of death. But people, when was the last time you deworm yourself? It's as simple as that. When was the last time you chose to make fruit your friend? When was the last time you just chose, let me go to the hospital, check my medical condition, my cholesterol level, my sugar level, my blood level, my BP, all those things. You shouldn't wait until I'm having small headache. Try to visit the doctor this year, just to make sure that you are fine. Exercise regularly. All those things, it may just sound like a normal today-to-day thing, but they are very key things that matters to ourselves. Take yourself out, find a cool environment or something that makes you feel relaxed. See your goal, write it out, type it, print it, and paste it. We teach people this, we teach everybody this thing, but some of us don't do it to ourselves. This evening is all about you. I want to, please don't do it 2023. I want to build a house. Go and ask for land. Ask for the price. What installment payments are available? How can you get the house started? Plan those things out. Write them down. How much it is? 10,000 naira, 12,000 naira. Okay, I'm going to be removing 100 naira. I'll be 10 kabo. I'll be 1,000 just for the purpose of this. Let's get it done. Let's get our lives the same way we are organizing, managing people in different organizations. Manage yourself. Get an accountability partner that's going to help you through. Accountability partner that is going to, you say you are going to do this thing, how far? You don't do them. And when you did not do it, you're not going to say because it's obligatory. I don't do them. Meanwhile, you know you have not done it. Because you know that, it's my own. 10,000, this money too small. I want to do it at once. My people, let's try and do all we can to make sure that we make this year our year. We make this year our own kind of personal development. I decide this year that I'm going to do this. I promise to love myself. I promise to do something for myself. I talk to a lot of people, and then you realize that most of the stress they are going through has to do for others. Plan for yourself. Take yourself out. Depression is everywhere. Challenges is everywhere. You can't go and go. You're like, we would say jokingly, I cannot come and go. And I cannot come I don't know where that came from. Go swimming. Enjoy yourself. Call a few friends, people you know that when you sit down with them and then the creativity in you comes out, the innovative you comes out. Find out those things. Surround yourself with those type of people. We already know these things. People that will kill your dream, don't. People that will bring you down, don't. But please, take yourself seriously. Tell yourself that, you know what? I'm going to do this for every single month or every single day or every single second. By the end of 2023, you will tell yourself, I said I was going to do this. Yes, I did it. Celebrate yourself. Celebrate yourself for every single small win that you did. At least after all said and done, this is what I was able to do for myself. Having to understand your vision, having to go and written them down, is the only thing that is going to keep you running, only the thing that will make you stand up from bed. I know how difficult these things can be when it comes to you doing it for yourself. I know. But when it comes to you doing it for other people, pyam, it is done. They will be praising you. So as much as you can, tell yourself, I'm doing me. I'm going to celebrate me this year. Yes, we have to be selfless. We have to sacrifice something for yourself as well. It's exercise, it's a car, it's a savings, it's whatever it is. For every single thing that you wrote about this vision, it is not just you, if you know. For the married ones, you have children, and then your children, you're going to leave a legacy. What is that legacy that people are going to come back to and say, oh, yeah, thank God Adetutu was able to pursue this dream. Thank God Adetutu was able to do this. She set a pace. We are pace setters. We find pathways. Oh, I want to achieve 5,000 naira, or I want to save up to 1.2 million at the ending of this month. Fine. It's for you, right? You tell yourself, okay, it's because of this particular purpose. You tag it. You find, of course, only you will not be able to come up with a 12 million, depending. You gather friends. You gather people. Oh, guys, is anybody doing a job elsewhere? I want to do 50K to 100K to be able to, you set yourself a goal. Let's gather those type of people. And let's get no money. You are still spending the same small money you have on some people, making hunger to catch yourself, depriving yourself of so many things that you can do, and you are doing it for others. It is beautiful. It is awesome. But appreciate yourself. Tell yourself, you know what, whatever it is that you have said I'm going to achieve, I'm going to achieve it. Don't let anything bring you down. Never give up on yourself. Work can be challenging. Organizations, CEOs, COOs, all of them like that, making my work miserable. They don't even understand what HR is, giving me headache. Improve yourself. Tell yourself, this year is going to be different. Everything about me has to glow. Everything about me has to change. Everything about me has to... People need to see a difference in whatever it is that we are doing. They were like, this person is becoming stingy. I have learned to say no because I'm a very serious chronic giver. I have tried to say no. Okay, let me try the video again. Can we see? Can you see me? Can we hear?
Yes, I can hear and I can see it.
Oh, yay. Thank God. Yay. Sorry?
I think the network is better now.
Oh, okay. Thank God.
It's very clear.
Okay, sorry about that. There's no light. Well, is it fine? Can everybody see me?
Can any other person confirm? It's clear from my end.
Okay, that's fine. Sorry, my gear went off and then, you know, apologies. So, of course, we all know this. So, I told myself, I need to do something different. I need to do me. I need to look back and say, Adetutu, thank God you took these steps. Thank God you did this for yourself. Even though you don't know what to do, how to go about it. Do not procrastinate when it comes to you. Take those actions. Take it for yourself. I want to learn something. You go for it. For this year, I just want to encourage each and every one of us to do us this year. Don't give up on yourself. Build yourself. Make yourself as beautiful as you can. Go to spa. Go to do pedicures. Take care of yourself. Whatever it is you have written down, whatever it is that you want to crush, as you are crushing it for everything, if you have a to-do list, 99% of whatever is on that to-do list, maybe for others, to you, you are checking it out, yes. But in that to-do list, put you to there that, okay, I'm doing this for me this year, and you should be able to tick it out. That's the little cup nugget I would like to drop for each and every one of us this evening. Thank you so much for having me, and thank you, really, for the beautiful thing. Thank you, everyone, and we hope to do more and more and more of this year. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. It's do have a good night rest from all of us. And remember, when you round up your year compass, it is very important to identify what you want to do to leave the world better than you met it. Always remember that. Thank you, everyone. It's been a nice evening. Thank you for sharing your evening with us.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for this session. It's so impactful.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
And Tade Tutu, thank you so much. Thank you for sharing all those nuggets. Man, my daughter is filled up. So thank you. Thank you so much. And yes, for the fun part, HR mentorship has all activities for this year. Our calendar is already out. We already posted it on all groups. So please, If you want to socialize, please don't hold yourself back. If you want to have fun, don't hold yourself back. Let it be your year, me year. So thank you once again, everyone. So the recording will be posted on our YouTube channel. The link is already in the chat box. Just in case you've not subscribed, please kindly do so. So thank you, everyone. To all the co-hosts for tonight, thank you so much, Irene. We appreciate you and we love you. So to everyone, all right, have a good night's rest. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Oh, Victoria, sorry that the meeting is over. But you can watch the recording, or it will be posted on our YouTube channel, so you can watch it. You still haven't missed yet. All right, thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. Vicky, I sight you. Thank you for joining.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, my boo.
You're welcome. Do you know where to stop it?
I'm trying to.
Okay, stop recording. Okay.